Hello, thank you for joining me on my workshop for making an incense holder. I am Zhu Ohm. I'm a contemporary ceramic artist based in Melbourne, Australia. And I would like to acknowledge the peoples of the Kulin Nation as the traditional custodians of the land and water upon which I work and make art. So grab a bit of clay. You kind of wrap it around your finger. We'll make the short barnacles first, which is around the size of the top finger joint. So to make the larger barnacles, you just grab a bit more clay, kind of mush it around your finger. If clay gets a bit crumbly or hard to work with, you can just add a bit of slip and water to it so it becomes soft and malleable again. But be mindful not to add too much because it can get sloppy. The thickness of these pieces should be around 3 to 5 millimeters. And then once you kind of wrap it around your finger, you can kind of smooth the outside a bit. I like to pinch the openings a little bit as well. Alrighty. So, to put these together, let's start with the middle ones, the two short ones. So, to join them together, I'll grab my needle tool and just start scratching into the side here and on this side as well. And then I'll dip my finger into some slip, put it on the area that I've scratched, and then join them by pressing them together. Put some slip on the scratch area. And press. Right, so I want to make sure the two barnacles in the middle are the shortest, but then I want to make sure that they can stand as well. So you need to make sure that at least 3 or 4 of the larger barnacles around the outside are level as well. So I will kind of like play with like the positioning of the barnacles. Once you have 3 large barnacles kind of level and kind of touching the table, it should start to stand up. Once you have like 3 or 4 barnacles kind of on the table and it's standing up, you can kind of lift the other barnacles off the ground to give it different heights, so it looks a bit more organic. And so here we go. Now is the time for refining a little bit. So I just like to smooth out the middle here a little bit. So they're fused together a bit better. So yeah, I think here we have our little incense holder. And when it's dry, it'll become whiter like this. And so you can bisque fire it. And once you bisque fire it, you can glaze it. So I've got an old sculpture here that's glazed. So I've made this piece around 5 years ago when I first started making ceramics. So one of my earlier pieces. This is incense my friend Jack got for me from Japan. Palo Santo is my favorite. It's harvested from trees that have died naturally as well, so it's quite eco. And I just love the smell. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the workshop.